Hey guys, welcome back. Today on The Untidy Artist, we will be making a rose fairy doll. I thought this would be a really fun tutorial to do before Valentine's Day. Let's grab our supplies and get started. The first thing you'll need is a flower fairy body. Now to do this, you'll grab a 3/4 of an inch wooden bead, a piece of floral wire, and some embroidery floss for the hair and the skin, and you're going to twist it into a doll. Now if you're new to flower fairy making with me, you'll want to check out my basic flower fairy tutorial where I go through step-by-step instructions how to assemble your doll. You can learn how to make a basic flower fairy by clicking the link here in the video, or I will be posting the link below in the comments. For your rose flower fairy, you will need a silk rose flower. Now, I found this bouquet of rose flowers at the dollar store, so they were very inexpensive. A fuller, more open rose flower will give you a fuller skirt, where a tighter, closed flower will give you more of a pencil style skirt. We will also be using one of the leaves from the bouquet. You'll need two different colors of embroidery floss. I have a red and a green here for her shirt and sash. And then we'll be making a rose crown for our flower fairy. So I found these little paper roses that were on wire in the Valentine scrapbooking section at my craft store. If you can't find something like this, just any little rose embellishment for her hair will do. I found these in the sewing section of my craft store, and I know this one is pink, but I have seen them come in red too if you wanted it to match your doll. You'll need a good pair of scissors, and then of course I've got my trusty glue gun set on low. The first step is to take your doll, and we're going to dress our doll. So grabbing the red embroidery floss, I place a small dab of glue right around her middle section or her waist, and we're going to start wrapping the thread around in an even layer up towards underneath her arms. So just in the same way that you wrapped the thread around your doll to create the body, we are going to create her clothing. You'll wrap your thread in an even layer, creating a V at the top for some sleeves for your doll's dress, and then work your way down to create a little pair of shorts for the doll, or a bodysuit. If you have questions or want more detailed step-by-step instructions on how to put the clothing on the doll, please refer back to my basic flower fairy tutorial where I go through more step-by-step basic instructions on how to do this part. And once we have our doll dressed in her red, we are going to take our green thread and create a sash for the doll. So place a small dab of glue right at your doll's waist, right on top of the red thread, and wrap the green around in an even layer. And I wrapped my thread down in an even layer and then back up to where I started, put another dab of glue, trim off the excess thread, and now your doll has a green sash. Because our rose flower fairy will have a rose flower skirt, I wanted to create some contrast by doing the green around the waist so it would kind of look like the bottom of the flower. Now I decided to use a more closed rose flower to give it more of a pencil skirt look for my little flower fairy. So pull your flower apart completely and then play around with the petals a little bit. You can actually fold them in half and hold them up to your doll to see how they'll look as a skirt. And now we want to cut an X right where the hole or opening was on our flowers, so that we can slide the skirt over her legs. So right in the center there, I'm going to cut an X. I cut down maybe an 1/8 to 1/4 of an inch, and then slide the petals onto your doll, starting with the top layers. And once you have them arranged the way that you like, take some glue and put a small dab of glue in between the layers, kind of pinching them into place. Do that in the front and in the back to secure her skirt. And then I grabbed one of the green leaves from the bouquet of flowers, and I'm going to place it on the back of her skirt. So I cut an opening into the leaves, and there were three leaves, and I just liked how they laid across the back of the skirt, almost like a bustle, kind of defining her waist and making the sash in the middle pop. And now, last but not least, we're going to style her hair. So with this part, you want to work slowly, Smooth out the embroidery floss until it's nice and smooth, and then you're going to lay your fairy face down and you're going to grab the end of the loop of the embroidery floss and loop it up and around and tuck the end piece of the embroidery floss right onto the back of her head where you've put a big dab of glue. Hold that down firmly so you can see that the embroidery floss creates a big loop, and then smooth it down carefully. And your fairy has a fancy hairdo. I found the best way to do the hair is to work slowly and to smooth it down as you go. And you can always go back and add a little bit of glue to hold different pieces down, but I really try and add as little glue as possible. Now this next step is completely optional. I decided to make a rose crown for my flower fairy. These little paper roses on wire were part of the Valentine's Day craft decorations. If you can't find this, remember this part is totally optional. Okay, so I separated these little flowers that were on wire, and I'm just going to twist them together two at a time. So I twist my first two together, kind of staggering the roses a little bit, and then I grabbed another rose and twisted that, layering it on top of the two that I had already twisted together. I'm using 5 of the roses total. And you want to make sure that you're spacing the roses evenly. Now I'm going to add my 4th rose, once again spacing it evenly and just twisting it to my first 3. And then take your last rose, apply that, and then I kind of bent it, cut off a big portion of the twisty stems, so I was only working with 1 stem. And I'm going to loop it around and twist the wire around my first rose. So I'm twisting the end of the wire back around to the first rose, creating my wreath. So I twist it about 1 time around, hold it up to my doll to make sure that it's going to fit, and that way I can make it bigger or smaller if I need, and you could see it was way too big. So I made it a little bit smaller, and once I have the size that I like, I'm going to twist that wire into place so it doesn't move around. And that's it, guys. You have this gorgeous rose flower fairy. I really love the green leaves on the back of her dress and, of course, her beautiful rose fairy crown. I think she's perfect for Valentine's Day. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. If you have any comments or questions, please post those below. I would love to hear any flower fairy ideas that you have. Please check out some of my other tutorials. Give this a thumbs up if you liked it, and if you haven't already subscribed, please do, because that would be awesome. Thanks. We'll see you next time.